Hi, it's Matt, and welcome to Collaboration Coach. This time we're going to look at how to add and configure a news web part to your SharePoint Intranet homepage. This video is taken from a class in my online school, so if you'd like to know more, then check out the link in the description. Okay, so let's start off on the Intranet homepage, because when people visit your Intranet, the first thing they'll see is this area in the top left. So that's where I want to put the most important information, and I think that's my company news. News is a key part of any intranet, and the distribution of current news should be one of its main goals. So I'm going to put my news web part up here. A web part is Microsoft's name for a block of content that you can add to a page. The news web part is your way of collating the news in one view and presenting it on your page. So how do we add a web part? Now, when I'm in page edit mode and I hover my mouse in any section, I'll see a line with a plus in it. I'll just choose the plus in the section I want to put the web part in, and it will show me a list of all the available web parts. And I can scroll through the list, and you can see there are web parts for all sorts of things, like text and images and videos. And there's also apps like YouTube and Twitter. To help me find the one I'm looking for, I can filter them by category. I can view them as a list or a grid. And the one I use most is the keyword search. I'm just going to type news and then choose the news web part that shows up. And it will be added to my page. When the news web part is added, it will have some placeholders for the news items. That's unless you've already added some news to your site. If you've already created some, they will be listed here instead. So the first thing I want to do to this web part is change the layout of the news stories. And I can do that by going to the pencil button on the toolbar here. The news panel will open up on the right-hand side, and I can go to the layout section in that panel, and I can choose the top story layout. This will put the latest story as a larger image on the left-hand side of the web part, and then the other three stories will be on the right and they'll be slightly smaller. It's just my preference, it's the way I like to lay out news, but you can experiment with the other layouts too. If I choose Save as Draft, now I can see what the news web part will look like. And you can see it's going to show me four pieces of news. Now, just for this demo, I'm going to add some news items so it will look nice, but you don't have to do this to complete the homepage. To create some news, I just choose the Add News button. Then I'll choose a blank template and then Create Post. I'll add a name here and I'm going to call it Wellbeing Events Are Coming Soon. Then I'll choose an image for the title area by choosing the image button here. I'm going to use the stock images and I'll put in a keyword search for well-being. Then I can choose an image and then insert. Now back on the news page, I just choose post news. And then it will show up on my homepage. Okay, so now I've created my news and it's all showing up in the news web part. I hope you found this useful and please remember to check out my class on creating an intranet homepage in my school. So thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.